So I think that leads us to a good question. It sounds like we're kind of tickling around something, which is, what would you have done to improve black sales? To grab whatever it's doing well and focus that on that or improve upon that, and what would you take out, Michael?
It's a pretty good question. I mean, for me, I would say just make it make more sense. Like, it doesn't, it, so obviously, you know, we talked about how, like, the whore's screwing this guy for free. It doesn't make sense. The fact that, there was some other, it was just.
Make it make sense.
Make it make sense. I would have liked to see more of John Silver. I know that we saw a lot of him, but it seemed also like the whole story was just focused on Flint. And yeah. I didn't really buy, or I didn't really like that he's like roughing up this guy that he needs information out of. Like, how is that going to help things? And like, so I thought that his little ruse at the end, where he kind of tricked the crew into voting for him by pretending that this guy stole the page out of the book and stuff like that, I thought that was a pretty good ruse. But mm-hmm. by that time, I just didn't care enough to find it that interesting either. So
yeah.
I guess that's the main thing, is just the characters were weak, in my opinion. And then because of that, the story fell short.
Mm.
Okay. I would agree with that. I do agree. I do agree with that. That would be, if it's my turn, that would
Sorry, Black Sails.
Yeah, well, I just, one of my notes I put was, I felt like, it was in the beginning, I felt like, he's really too nice to be captain. Like, I just felt like I was looking for more of a stronger personality. And then at the very
you
end,
you singleton
like,
lover,
someone's head, and I was like, "Oh, he's gonna smash someone's head." Okay, I was like, "I guess that's where you know." But I kind of wanted to see that strong personality throughout the whole thing. I thought, I mean, he just seemed like not like a pushover, but yeah. How did I mean? I don't know. Like then that might have gone back to maybe I was a little confused about, you know, it sounds like he was, you know, doing messing up or whatever. But again, he was just very kind and very. You know, thoughtful, and then all of a sudden, rah! And I was like, okay, you know.
Yeah, that was a bit of a stretch too. I mean, obviously he's a pirate captain, so he must have done something kind of brutal to get there. But yeah, it was just kind of a huge switch from what he was before. I agree with you that he, in the beginning of the story, he's the civilized captain. He's the he's the educated one they talked about. Right. And then all of a sudden at the end, he snaps and he's just like beating this guy.
Yeah, which I think I like it. It just was like, it just took me by surprise. And then, yeah, I just felt like all the characters have really good ideas. Like, I bet on the breakdown, if you saw it, you're like, oh, yeah, that's good. And then it just didn't feel like their personalities weren't at, you know, character-wise, within reason, at a 10, you know what I mean? Like, if you're shooting for, like, a really strong character, because that's who you are, that's the person, the character is, I thought that, it felt like, maybe there's too many people, I don't know.
Yeah, they used the word aloof when describing him. I'm like, okay, that's kind of a nicer version of what Michael's saying, I think, is that he was just kind of a little detached, a little aloof. But I'll tell you, I kind of thought about this when I was watching it, just at the end, when it was ending it, what was necessarily, you know, kind of wrong with the first episode, or what I would have changed, is I think they tried to do too much. I think they just tried to introduce too many scenarios, tried to introduce too many storylines and too many characters. And I think that could have been remedied by having much less on land. Keep it on the boat, you know, on the ship. We got all the storyline on the ship. It was still working. We were following it along with the first captain that got taken over. We're watching this. We're learning about Singleton. We're learning about, I forgot the captain's name, Flynn. you know, we're learning about everything's kind of working. Flint. And once they go on land, at first I was like, ooh, awesome. This is really exciting and this is really cool. But 2 or 3 minutes in, I start kind of getting a little lost. I didn't really realize it until about 10 minutes on land. Then after a while, we're learning there's all these new characters, and then they start really introducing like the overall politics of the region. I'm like, dude, we're still learning names of 2 or 3 main characters, and you're right. trying to give us the politics of the entire world already? Give us episode 3 for that. Like,
well, also, seemed like at the end, it was like 3/4 of the way through the story that they introduced this third guy who's vying for captainship, who's this guy Vane.
Right.
Like, originally, I was like, okay, you got Flint and you got Singleton. Okay, that we can deal with. But then all of a sudden, there's this third guy. Like way at the end, they throw in this third guy.
That guy, Vane. Mm-hmm.
Which I think that would have been great if they cut out most of the overall political stuff of the region and of the colonies and of the island and stuff. If it was just about that ship, and then Vane comes in, and then you're like, ooh, the plot thickens. That's a good way to end it, right? And then they could still go on land for 2 or 3 minutes and introduce 1 or 2 characters. But there was just too much. If they'd cut out 20 minutes out of that land stuff and just introduce 1 or 2 people there, and then right back out on sea, and then Vane pops in on land doing his own thing, that's okay. But it was just... They just tried to introduce too many people and too many things. And I feel like if they concentrated.
Here's what we're going to do. It's going to be like episode 1 of Game of Thrones, except instead of talking about people that aren't on screen, everybody's going to be on screen.
They're going to be there.